hot water systems for canteen applications. So when we say canteen, it is for different uses inside a canteen, for boiler, feed water preheating, and also for cleaning. So traditional construction of a, there are two types. We'll first look at the traditional simple thermosiphon systems, where the circulation is only because of thermosiphon. There are, if you look closely, there are no pumps in the system. So the cold water goes in, gets into the collector, then gets heated up because of the sun. All the sun rays falls on this collector. The hot water then gets heated up and is generated and goes into a tank. And this process keeps circulating unless the tank temperature becomes uniform. And whenever the consumer or the person who requires hot water draws hot water from the tank, there is like a small valve arrangement, a float valve arrangement, which is connected to a feed water tank. Basically, there is feed water. And this water keeps getting filled in. So this is a very, very simple arrangement of a thermosiphon system. One of the problems with this system, if you would notice, is that as soon as I start drawing water from here, it immediately rushes to fill in with fresh water. So as my sun keeps adding hot water, my temperature keeps increasing. It goes up to a very high temperature. But as soon as I start adding, removing hot water from the system, my temperature keeps going down. So if I look at my temperature versus time profile, depending on the sunlight, depending on the consumer withdrawal, it keeps fluctuating. So I'm not able to get a constant temperature value. It is of lot of use if I'm able to get a constant temperature value, because then I can for sure say that in my canteen application, I can save X amount of energy. So now we look at aspiration energy's innovative design in designing the thermosiphon system essentially for delivering constant hot water temperature. So now we'll go forward and look at how aspiration energy's two tank system solves this problem of variation in temperature. So there is a very simple circuit modification that we have attempted, and using our control algorithm, what we have done is that instead of having a single tank like this, we have water being delivered into the feed water being supplied to the tank, and this is called as the primary tank. And once throughout the day, on day one, when I'm starting the system, the solar heat is added to the tank and it reaches a certain temperature, which is desired temperature T1. And I have another system, another storage tank here, which at the end of the day, so basically you have starting sun going from here to here, at the end of the day, we have this water being transferred to the system. Now, this system is full of hot water at a constant temperature T2, and this is being delivered to my consumer. And if you notice this arrangement, this temperature contains water at a constant temperature. So no matter how much water I draw, I don't add fresh water into this tank. So this gives me a constant output of a desired capacity. So if I'm designing a system for say 5000 liters per day, this tank is rated at 5000 liters. So this has that 5000 liters of hot water available for the customer. And then on the next day, this particular primary tank starts fresh. So now as soon as I deliver all my hot water into this tank, now my feed water tank starts delivering cold water, and this thing is filled up with cold water. Now it is ready for a fresh day. So the next day, this again does the same loop of the sun adding heat throughout the day for 7-8 hours. The sun is adding heat to this tank. It is filled up with hot water, and this process repeats. So this is a simple two-tank system which is has been installed at one of our customer sites, and we have successfully delivered a constant temperature of 75 and even up to a temperature of 95 degrees centigrade. If you look at it, we have solved the problem of constant temperature, but we also now have a problem of a complex control algorithm where the transfer rate between the primary tank and the secondary tank is through a multiple of solenoid valves, and then for each arrangement we have such two tanks which has to be insulated, and also the problem that when my this tank is not fully emptied out, then this tank again still contains a little bit of hot water which is not fully utilized. So in order to simplify that, and also here what happens is if my temperature is too high, or if this tank is not fully emptied, I have a very low circulation rate, and then I'm not able to utilize my sun's availability fully. So with this, what we have done is that we have come up with a canteen system version 2, essentially, which is based on forced circulation. So essentially we looked at thermosiphon as one of the options, and the second one is the force circulation system. So now we look at how the circuit, the thermal circuit innovation from aspiration allowed us to achieve a constant temperature with just a single tank design. So previously we looked at single tank design makes leads into a reduction in temperature, fluctuation in tank temperature on the output. Now we'll look at the force circulation design. In this particular case, again we have the same arrangement, and then you have the feed water coming in, and it is feed water is coming in from a feed water tank. Essentially you have like a feed water tank, and the water comes in from this tank, it goes through, and it goes through basically what is called as a circuit arrangement, where we have multiple ways to control the flow. Basically this is hot water flow. As soon as this goes in, it's hot water flow here and goes into a single loop and falls into a single tank. And there is always a small bypass arrangement where the water is drawn from this tank and recirculated. In this particular case, since there is no thermosiphon, we need a pump. Basically we need a pump to send the flow through it. So the simple innovation in this design is that all these valves are designed to accommodate only enough flow so that my temperature here is always achieved. So how is this done? So essentially we all know that my overall heat input is nothing but mass of water, the specific heat and the temperature difference. So I know what is my temperature that's coming in, T1, and I know what is my temperature going out, T2. Basically I know the temperature difference, I already know the specific heat of water. So if I know the temperature difference, based on what is my delta T or temperature difference required, and I already know what is my Q available. Q is basically the sunlight. So Q is essentially my heat available from the sun, and this varies with regards to season, with regards to time of the day. So basically with regards to basically availability of Q, my mass flow rate m dot, or the flow rate of water, changes. So it basically comes from a very low number and very high number throughout the day, and then again drops back. So it ensures that I'm utilizing my sun's potential for the entire day, so that I'm all, even though there's variation in flow rate, but the temperature delivery is constant. So the tank is always filled with usable water at the desired temperature. How we have achieved this is a very simple innovation, that each of this is a flow control orifice, so that I have three levels of control, and depending on the availability of heat, which is determined by the temperature here, I will be able to select one of these valves to allow the flow rate. So as soon as I select, say for example, the high valve, the medium valve or the low valve, and a combination of these three, I will be able to deliver the desired flow rate for the desired temperature. So this is our simple innovation in terms of force circulation for achieving a constant temperature solution.